baby. Will you eat that there snack cracker in your special outfit for me, please?
Hello, welcome to another episode of Two Johns No Waiting. We actually have John here today on camera. You've heard him off camera introducing thing. He's not busy today, actually running down a guest. And I understand we've got a sponsor for the show.
We have our first sponsor on Two Johns No Waiting. We're anxious to let them air their commercial this morning.
All right, roll that commercial.
Well, hey, y'all. This is Cap Appalachia here with Disability. Listen, do you all ever wake up with a nagging pain in your neck that just won't go away? I do, every day. It's Mammy. She'll get on me and she'll say, do something today. And I'll say, woman, ain't nobody rushed Michael Andretti when he was painting that cistern chapel. She has no appreciation for art. But it don't stop there. Do you know what me and Disability have to reach for to get rid of a big, nasty nagger? No, not a gun, nor a rope. We reach for Grandma Butters Ransom. Yes, Grandma Butters, she goes to all ends to get the best bouquet of ramps that money can buy. And you pop the top on this and woo, doggy, does it fill the house with smell. Makes him sneeze and it just about stunts his growth. But I tell you, it runs Mammy to her mama's for 2 days, and I can get some serious superhero work done. And it's good to eat, too. You take a big spoonful, put some sardines in it. I call that a swamp salad. And it works. It makes it feel better all over. So, when things aren't going good, I tell you, you need to get rid of a nagging pain, open up a can of Grandma Butter's Ramp. They're available down there at the Piggly Wiggly. You all tell them it's Captain Central. Come on, Disability. Let's go. Come on, Disability. Hey there, Disability.
John, that is our sponsor for the show?
Yeah, yes, John, that is our sponsor.
Grandma Butters? I mean, they're paying for that spot? I mean,
not in money, John.
I don't even want to know.
It's best that you don't.
I mean, that's all we can get this day and age is Grandma Butters with the Captain.
Well, times are tough. Gas is $3.25 a gallon.
I know. It's nothing but damn thievery right there. Damn thievery. Okay. Here we got Carl here.
Carl is here today. He is here to address the controversial statements that he made on last week's show that generated quite a bit of mail.
Yeah, a little bit inflammatory. We did contact the lawyer about that, right?
Lawyer's been contacted, and they believe that most things can be taken care of if Carl does an adequate apology.
Okay. All right, so Carl's here. Let's bring him. We got him down from the courthouse, right?
He's here eating some cookies down in the back of me.
Okay, bring him in from the green room back there, Ned. Let's bring Carl in. Hello, YouTubers, and here we are again with another episode of Two Johns No Waiting. Due to several viewer mail letters, we've brought Conspiracy Carl back to answer some of his fan mail. Thanks, Ned, for booking Carl back on the show. Ned, I think you have a couple of letters you've selected to respond to.
Yeah, John, he gave me the letters. I'm getting blamed for the mail that these boys got with this show, and quite frankly, it's not so. It's another conspiracy. Let me tell you why. I have two letters. The first letter is written by boys in Kentucky, one named Cletus, the other named Brooks. It's written in crayon. They write on here and they think that the captain's not funny. Well, John, I've seen this captain guy. He is funny. He's dang funny. He might be a Humvee short of a convoy, and he might be a mortar round short of a barrage, but he is funny. But there's a reason these poor simple boys in Kentucky don't find him funny. All those years and generations of inbreeding in Kentucky have caused the brain malformations in the youth. Two areas of the brain are affected. Number one, the humor center. That's why these simple boys find the Dukes of Hazzard funny and Hee-Haw funny, but they don't find Captain Appalachia funny. And the second part of the brain that has not developed, scientific fact, Ned, is the part of the brain that picks appropriate relationships. That's why they want to have sexual relations with their aunts, their sisters, their cousins, and yes, sheep. These boys in Kentucky like a little bling around their girl's neck, like a kettlebell or one of those collars you use with an invisible fence that keep their ugly girls in the yard. That's the reason that these boys have problems.
Yeah, I'm sure that won't generate any more mail, Carl. Okay.
What? It's the truth. These boys... Now listen to me, boys. I gotta talk strictly to you right now. This is nothing to cry in your moonshine about. Nothing at all. Yeah. Don't be getting all liquored up and driving to school on the short bus on Monday, and there ain't no reason to get Ma and Pa to help you write another crayon letter here. We can't read it anyway. It ain't not spelled right. So just get a grip.
Thanks, Carl.
Got that other letter.
Yes, letter number two.
This is from Carlene in Modesto, California. It writes things that say I'm objective. I'm just not a very nice guy, and the things I said were in poor taste. That's not what this letter means. This letter was written by Carlene in Modesto, California. So that means this is the Carlene that she and I had a fling back in the mid-70s, let me tell you. She knew that Carl was a love machine. But she lost me when she... there's too much kink in that armor, John. Could not tolerate it when she started talking about cooking spray, a hamster, and a Cub Scout uniform. Carlene, that ain't Carl. You had to hit the road, and she ain't never got over it. She has followed me the ends of the earth, and now she's taking out a chance to get at you boys through me. Carlene, give it up. You ain't never getting all this. So go on about your ways and have a good life. Now that's the letters.
Thank you, Carl, for that enlightening response to the people, good people of Kentucky, and Carlene.
Carlene.
Carlene from California. We appreciate you coming, Carl, and I guess we'll catch you back down at the courthouse.
Yeah, but you don't know when. Nobody knows when, but I'll be there. Okay. Look for me.
Okay. We want to say thanks to Carl. I'm sure we'll have you back on for
you might
a few more letters, you Carl. Might.